I'm a stunner, I'm a boss, I can do what I want to. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot him to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I want to. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot him to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on my old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Stunned like no one stunned. She curved me back then, came back, so I swung her. I ain't going out like no sucker. Had to let it burn like Usher. Gave a rush for an hour, Chris Tucker. You can never stay me for another. I had to wait my time like a buffer. I'm that dude, I stutter. Ball hard, might get a tick. Bought a push start for a got a check. Drip too hard, made it. I know she won't forget that we met. She hit her, broke it down, she a wreck.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League takes us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Buffalo Bills and the Los Angeles Rams. And we are underway from SoFi Stadium. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. On first down, Allen. This ball complete to the tight end, Sweeney. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
56, 56.
Allen now looks to throw. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. Singletary is in. Touchdown, Bills. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. First carry now for the Memphis man, Darrell Henderson. He'll push forward for about 4 up to the 23. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. From the gun, a give to Henderson. Takes this to the 27, give him 4 yards.
Back-to-back 4-yard runs. Now look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now 3rd and 2, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run. Henderson will try and run for the first. An ideal start defensively. They already have the touchdown. Now they get the stop.
Just like they drew it up on the chalkboard. Does that sound dated? Right? Am I out of touch a little bit?
It's all right.
All right, grease board, heck, computer. Exactly what you want, though. Score on your first drive. Stop them on the first drive defensively.
And he's going to have a Rams first down as he's got this up to about the 34-yard line. They're able to keep the drive alive 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. Henderson now on first and 10. And some space here. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
They'll try the air now with Stafford. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. To throw is Stafford. And oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way you wanted to start this ball game, as it brings up fourth down. Gay's kick is good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there, because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things, because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. Oh, Allen cannot get away, and down he goes. The perennial Pro Bowler Aaron Donald gets the sack. Throwing on second and long. Allen going deep for Diggs. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs. 75 yards, and the Bills will extend their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. They'll fake it. Now Stafford.
That'll be swung out wide here for Henderson.
He finds some open field here. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. That's a gain of 13, first down Rams.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On the handoff, Henderson. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line.
58 yards on the ground for him so far.
Throwing on second and three. Stafford, throw left side, complete to Kupp. It's the first catch of the game for Kupp, and he's got a first down. And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Off of play action, here's Stafford. And that is incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now Stafford. And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. A big play on the catch and run, covering 34 yards. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Stafford looks to throw again. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. That's sacked by Tremaine Edmonds.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. But that's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down. Now a handoff, Henderson. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. It's a pickup of three, but it brings up what will be an interesting four. Try to force it to Hopkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the five. He's at the 50, the 40, the 20, 10. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. The mistakes continuing to pile up, and it looked like they were going to be able to eat into that deficit. Instead, now the deficit is even larger.
Yeah, they were on a march with a chance to get back within a score, but now that deficit continues to grow.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. It's caught inside the five, and he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. And that's something you almost never see nowadays. When you fake it, you're at the 15-yard line on a PAT as opposed to just going for it from the two.
I'm sorry. I know they got it, and congratulations to them, but it's just not a good play. I mean, the risk-reward is really off the charts. Not in your favor. Run your offense out there. Put it on the two-yard line if you want to go for two. But I'll be darned. They ended up getting that one, didn't they?
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And with good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. On first down, Singletary. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Allen off the play fake. They'll roll him out right. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Give him seven there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
On play action, Allen. Going for it all. He will find Diggs in the end zone. Touchdown, Buffalo. Stephon Diggs, as the first half is winding down. And the Bills would extend their lead here just before halftime. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
Well, I have to admit, I'm scratching my head a little bit here trying to make sense of what I just saw. Number one, huge lead. Just kick the extra point and be done with it. Number two, if you are going to go for two, just line up and go for it from the two-yard line. Why make it so difficult? That's a long way to go to try and pick up some points.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line as they go to work with 12 seconds on the clock. He's going to air it out deep for Woods. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Levi Wallace with a pick, and his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. So good field position for the Bills as they come up first and 10 at their own 37. So after the INT, it's Allen sliding out of the pocket. Going deep for Diggs. And incomplete on the deep ball. Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver. And it's second down.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
Rolling to his right. First down and more for Allen. And finally taken down at the 44-yard line. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Rams set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail here as we resume play. Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster of a first half. So where do they go from here?
Well, first thing they have to remember is that what's done is done, and there's...
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Gregory Russo. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Now left side on the swing pass. And some room to maneuver. And he is finally out of bounds across midfield at the 40-yard line.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
It's caught by Jackson. room here to run. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Stafford. And Woods has it complete. Not much there, only a yard.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Again, it's Stafford. This is caught, and they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Henderson. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one. Once more with Henderson. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. This Buffalo defense has stood their ground. This is third and goal. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Matthew Stafford. A three-yard touchdown run. And the Rams are able to cut into this lead as they score on the opening drive of the second half. So the call's made by Sean McVay. They're going to go for two. Stafford's going to try and throw for it. And he's got it for the two-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You could say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime and sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. Here's Allen. He'll get this out wide to Singletary. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 14 yards, and the Bills will get a new set of downs.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I'm getting a sense that the momentum of this game is changing since the break. Nice play there, and this D is fired up.
On play action, Allen. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off at the 39. Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
To throw on second and 10. Stafford, and he'll find Henderson there. It's complete. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Rams on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is third and 11. Now it's Stafford. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. 11 yards there, just like last play. Boy, an effective play there, getting their wideouts involved in the run game.
And what they're always hoping on that type of a play, that they can get to the end of the line and have a chance to turn it upfield as he did there. That means they controlled the blocking and took care of the defensive end or the outside linebacker to give him that lane.
And I guess I need to clarify, I said getting their wideouts involved in the run game, but of course that was actually a pass as he popped it forward. He was going right back to Cooper Kupp. That'll bring up second down.
Zebra!
To the air again, Stafford. This is caught, it's Woods. And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills 19. A good pick up there of 20 yards. From the red zone now, Stafford. And it's caught, touchdown. Matthew Stafford finding Cooper Kupp for the touchdown there. And the Rams have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Well, they needed three scores to have any chance. There's the first of the three as they get into the end zone.
Yeah, Brandon, I think that our guys at Next Gen Stats in charge of the win probability are probably saying your chances still aren't great. But now, you still got more than 3 minutes to go. You got to focus on the task at hand, which is going to be getting the football back as quickly as possible.
And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. McKenzie will not return this and it'll be brought out to the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Now all of a sudden, we've got an interesting game here. You just saw them go down and score a touchdown. And what was a comfortable lead at halftime is down to a two-score game.
And so the obvious thought is they've got to ramp things back up again. Got to get the offense into high gear. But we've seen this before when you've kind of been in shutdown mode for a while thinking that you're okay. It's hard to mash the gas again and have everything work perfectly. They've got to fast together a good drive right here and now.
Because defensively, got to be feeling confident. They haven't allowed a point this half. Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 11 yards and a Buffalo first down. Now Allen. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception. And that means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to him and hold him for just a short gain.
To throw again on second down. Allen. He's got the connection to Cole Beasley. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. 36 yards on the play. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Flush to his right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line. Second and goal. And Allen is actually going to throw it here, escaping the pressure right. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Josh Allen, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Bills will add on to their lead.
Well, I'd have to...
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Activated.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me something.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it.
Brass.
I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go.
When the kick off the bomb, run it back.
Home.
Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept
the pack.
Familiar with the scrubber, look, I'm coming up from scratch.
Nothing.
Huddle with my pain, then I turned it to some rats.
Celebrate.
Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands, I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gon' tackle your little man.
Get
let's get activated, let's get activated.
Activate.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go.
QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me something.
That's another set, cause I be running through it.
Brass.
I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go.
Pop out, treat this block like an end zone.
What?
Score.
Check it.
Benji calling money my ringtone.
Hundreds.
Or blue. Put her in a friend zone. She turned on more.
Ooh.
Take one for the team. I do that for my boys.
Bread. Gang.
Time ticking. I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man. I bet we win it. Go hard or go home. It's survival of the fittest.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the Steel City at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up with the Buffalo Bills. Here we go from Heinz Field as Chris Boswell tees it up and boots it away. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And we will not get a run back here to start. It's a touchback, and it will come out to the 25.
Check it, Eddie.
Man, that's what I do.
Allen now on first down. Finding Knox there, complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A good pickup there, a 22. And some good running out of the gates as he takes this up to the 33. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. On the handoff, it's Singletary. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. There on the tackle, Minka Fitzpatrick. And now they'll throw with Allen. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. A good decision in the end to pull it and run. Gets him 9 yards and a first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Operating from the red zone now, Allen. That'll be taken in by Beasley. Touchdown, Buffalo. Cole Beasley there to make the grab. And the Bills take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Now the try here for the point after. And it's 7-0 Buffalo. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Returning from his end zone is Ray McLeod. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. A first carry for Najee Harris. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
There he goes, right side. And now look at this, big gain, but a fumble. Now this is picked up by the Bills, and his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. And partner, I know hindsight's always 20-20, but man, just in general, those laterals, they can be so risky, and we see the risk that can be involved right there.
And you just have to know, and we've seen it because we've been at a lot of practices. It's not something that's practiced very often. You know, in that situation, you don't see guys really working on it. Maybe like we're bringing the rugby guys in to help us with tackling, maybe we ask them to help us with the laterals as well and make that a better play.
Here's second and 10. Throwing now is Allen. And he slings one that's incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a 3rd and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. To throw, it's Allen. Being chased out left. And finding Emmanuel Sanders here. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. A sizable 16-yard chunk there. The drive continues. They'll run on 1st down. Singletary. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. So they fake the handoff. Now Allen. Eluding the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. Play action. Now it's Allen. And he fires one, but incomplete.
Now that's a good bounce back after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive. Just 1 1st down permitted and then out. Obviously no loss of confidence with that defense, and now they get to turn it back to their offense.
And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on 4th down. They're going to try and throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And that will force a turnover on downs. Now a 1st down carry for Harris. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Up to make the play defensively, Tre'Davious White. The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. Here's Roethlisberger. He gets it complete to Harris. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the 1st quarter of play. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. On 1st down, it's Harris. He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4.
Forty-nine.
To throw here, Roethlisberger. And he's going to go down here, a sack. They push him back to the 34.
Ed Oliver, that time, the one to get in there and bring him down.
Tell you what, he did not have much time there to scan the field before he was ducking and covering.
Did it appear to you, as it did to me, that the defensive front won their play really quickly? Meaning the guys in front of them had almost no chance to block them. They were on him in a hurry.
Boswell's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get three of them.
Yeah, that's when your kicker can really come to your rescue, because you know after the sack, there was a little consternation there. Are we out of field goal range? Are we going to be able to get three? In this case, he stepped right up and gave them exactly what they needed.
After the successful field goal try, here's Boswell to send it away.
From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield.
Check, 93 is the mic, 93 is the mic. Too little.
Half 10.
Check, 93 is the mic, 93 is the mic.
Man out.
To the air, Allen. Flushed out right. And he wisely will throw that one away. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. So the shotgun snap to Allen. It's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. Takes this to the 45. Got a little space after that nice move. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Now Allen.
And he'll get this underneath to Singletary.
And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 14 yards, and the Bills will get a new set of downs. 2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score.
Come on, fellas. Check.
A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coach's 2-minute drill.
Now Allen again. Dancing to his left. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And down inside the 15 he goes. He's been a one-man wrecking crew these last couple of plays. This time, 18 more and a first down. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Buying time to his left. That is caught. It's Beasley. Touchdown, Buffalo. Cole Beasley. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Bills will add on to their lead. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And it's caught inside the five. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more.
All right, partner, one more time. Our whole lives, you put the ball on the three-yard line, kick the extra point. 2015, they put it on the 15 to kick the extra point. 2016, they said, we're leaving it there. So if you want to fake it, and they got it.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive.
And a first half that really has not been kind to them. A late opportunity here to maybe make some inroads on this deficit before half.
And this drive's going to go a long way towards telling us whether they actually have a chance to come all the way back in this game or not.
Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Here's Roethlisberger. Short little throw to Ebron. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Johnson, the intended target, and now it's second down. Now it's Roethlisberger. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. He'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 11 more on that one and another first down. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Pressure applied and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. Another try after the first down sack. Roethlisberger. Here's Johnson with a reception. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he'll go down, brought down at the 20-yard line.
These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles, and that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out because the entire game, he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. But gutsy call there. Yeggs at the locker room with a lead, tried the onside kick. It didn't work.
And you just wonder what the gain was there. They were already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kick-started things going in the opposite direction.
And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. They run again with Harris. And again, this Buffalo defense there in run support to stop him behind the line. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a third down and 12. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. To the right side to Eric Ebron. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Roethlisberger. Oh, hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. Mike Tomlin takes a shot here, but to no avail. And the Bills are going to get the football back. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 43. Allen now looks to throw. And he will slide to a halt at the end of that one. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. Allen. And this one caught by Beasley. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 15 yards that time and a Buffalo first. Oh, he didn't spike it. He faked it. Forced out to his left.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Second and 10.
Here we go, here we go. Check, butt set. Check, butt set.
From the gun, it's Allen.
Go,
that's
going to
be caught. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs, 31 yards. And the Bills will extend their lead.
No lead safe in the new NFL, but this score is really going to give them some needed breathing room.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. Floating one incomplete.
Partner, that type of a lead, and they're going to fake it from the 15 to try and pick up a two-point play instead of kicking it through the posts. Come on, man. Put that in mothballs. Come on. What? Come on. Don't do that.
Put that in mothballs.
Yeah, preserve that for it. That's an ancient relic, faking it. I can understand you want to rub it in a little. You fake it when you snapped it from the 3. But from the 15... mothball that bad boy, just like my grandmother had.
Yeah,
in her attic, the stuff she used to preserve.
It smelled terrible.
Too.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned him 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
It was Teron Johnson that time who had that play covered from the start. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
They're going on fourth down. It's Roethlisberger. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. The conversion is successful with a sizable gain of 13, and the decision to go for it looks like a smart one. Off the play fake. Here's Roethlisberger. Flush to his right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
On the give, this is Harris. And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. A 3-yard pickup on second and 4. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. And he's got the first down before being taken down at the 46.
And that's why you spend a first-round draft pick on a running back. Not for just the fancy runs, but these dirty, gritty third and ones, third and twos. That's why you draft him.
Go! Check 52. 50.
They'll run on first down. Harris. And he's going to be stopped at about the 37. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Now they'll throw it with Roethlisberger. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had it and dropped it. That is an unforced error there, and it takes away what could have been a touchdown. The Steelers on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. Here it's third and two.
Check 50, check 50.
Alert, alert.
Now it's Roethlisberger. Short little throw to Ebron, and he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to convert by plenty there on third and one. On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. Again, it's Roethlisberger. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down. Here we go. It's Roethlisberger on fourth down. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Levi Wallace with a pick. And to the 12. That's where it stops. The return is halted at the 12-yard line. Well, I guess an interception at this point on fourth down is just as bad as an incomplete pass. Either way, the ball goes over to the other side.
Yeah, it's a tough spot to be in this late in the game, and there's not a whole lot he could do there. And he winds up giving the ball away.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Fighting a safety valve here. That's complete. And brought down, but not before reaching the 25. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
Well, it may seem a little unorthodox to some people. Got the lead, fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
No, that is his game, and that's what they're going to ride.
Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. From the 30 on second down, Allen escaping the pressure right. He's got his target. It's the tight end, Knox.
You ain't nothing!
And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Dawson Knox, 70 yards. And the Bills will add on to their lead.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. I mean, he's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving them up.
4 touchdown, and it's intercepted at the goal line. The safety, Terrell Edmonds, picks it.
Well, as most teams do in their two-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted, and remember, if you pick it off, you get a chance to take it all the way back and get 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case there, but that's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside. Well, there you go, just your everyday leading big, and you'll...